Hello.
Hey.
Welcome back to the Only Ones Laughing podcast.
Episode 7. We're here.
Episode 7.
We've done it. Got a special one for you, ladies and gents. We've got a co-host.
Woo!
A third member. Reveal yourself.
Hi.
Hi. So we got Tom Donaghy with us today.
Yo. CGI Master Poly Jedi.
Yeah.
Name's getting longer and longer. It'll be like a paragraph in next year or something.
So what episode were you on? In the past?
I was on episode 3, I believe.
Yeah, so Tom told the famous McDonald's crown story on episode 3, and we need to get him in to be our first in-studio co-host.
In person.
In person guest, this is weird, but I like it. Oh, yeah.
Tom came more prepared than us, so he won't be invited back.
It's already shown us on list.
I mean, I have 5 bullet points.
Yeah, but that's still 5 more than me and Aiden combined.
I've got this old dusty list that hasn't changed since episode 1.
Yeah, guys, let's just rip on ourselves. Right, so what have you got written down for us?
It was basically what I've done this week.
Oh, nice. Well, that's how we like to kick off every show, go for it.
What you got up to?
So, I had Subway for the first time in like 6 months, which was great.
Damn.
Yeah, totally missed it. Didn't realize how good it actually was.
Mm.
Lockdown life. No, it's
did you do pickup or deliver?
Just went in, had a standard living, new normal.
What did you go for? I know this isn't that interesting, but
spicy Italian footlong on Italian herb and cheese with marinara sauce.
Grated cheese?
No cheese, toasted, please.
What?
Hot sauce, cucumber, and sweet corn.
Who the hell is
chips,
this guy?
Beans, and chili?
Can I get everything that's really hot and boring, please?
You miss it. Trick there. Italian BMT on hearty Italian.
Yeah.
Just mayo and lettuce. That's all you need.
And
you
the trick
to get
is
anything else.
An Aiden special.
And then a Coca-Cola, and then just wait for your stomach to erupt.
Pretty much. Wait for the fireworks.
Oh, man.
You have a thing where you prefer the smell of walking past Subway than actually eating it.
Subway smells so much better than it tastes.
Is that because that's free?
Maybe. But like when you walk past it, it's like a really like homely, warming like smell, and I think it's just the smell of the bread being baked, and they probably just push it to the front of the shop like a lot of places do. Mm. But whenever you then eat it, it's like, where did that smell come from?
It's just not
like
in
it
the
smells
sandwich.
So good, and it's just nowhere to be seen. And now I've just got a really squished baguette
that I paid £5 for. Thanks for that.
They are always just really squished, but in the adverts they look
squished
like
and wet as soon as they put them in that bag as well.
Yeah,
it's just
yeah.
I don't know. I enjoyed it, but yeah, it has its faults.
I do like Subway. I enjoy it. I just
you got to be in the mood for it.
Yeah. Otherwise, I prefer getting really wet, soggy sandwiches from Boots.
Oh god, freezing cold.
Oh god, bad cuts of everything. Yeah. Needlessly overpriced.
They're just
but fun.
Like they're obviously not wet and soggy, but they're just so cold. That like, and also the filling has been in there for a while.
Oh yeah.
And it
yeah.
just when you take that first bite and it's like fresh out the fridge, and it's just
squelchy.
Yeah, you're like
the sandwich is older than the bio itself.
Because you could quite easily just shut your eyes, bite into it, and be like, you dunk this in water. Nah, it's not quite that wet.
Like some sort of speed eating competition.
You're like slurping as you're eating.
Sucking on a wet flannel.
Yeah, that'd be $3.29, please.
What Subway was this? Which Subway was this?
That was the one on Mutley Plain.
Was it sunny or was it cold when you were there?
Was Matey in there? The dude who looks like Mackenzie Crook.
No. I haven't had. Well, I haven't been to that Subway in like 2 years or something. So when I went back, I was expecting the same people to be there for some reason. I don't know why.
Yeah.
And yeah, no, it's really, really good. But yeah, I missed it. I didn't realise how much. But like, that's my fix now. I'm probably good for another year.
Yeah.
And I'll talk about it again when I come back on the podcast.
Yeah, I did home delivery of McDonald's like a couple of weeks ago.
Sly bitch.
And it was just one of those, like, I was on the app and I was really hungry and I didn't really have any food in. And the time frame of like delivery was like 10 to 20 minutes.
Jesus
Christ. I was like, that's really fast. So
you're in a prime location, aren't you though?
Yeah, But it comes from like right at the bottom of town, so I have to pay extra for delivery, which is annoying because it's just a bit far away, but it was worth it. It was really good.
Is it good?
Yeah. I mean, it's as good as a takeaway McDonald's can be because it only takes...
It's going to lose something on the way, isn't it?
Yeah. McDonald's is like, you have to eat it while it's hot. Otherwise...
Yeah, whilst they're still making it, you just...
Please burn me. I still haven't had Taco Bell yet. Then that's been there for like a year.
It was...
Why don't you just drink a bottle of water? It tastes the same.
Shots fired! Oh, man. I know it's like... It's the hangover food that everyone kind of likes, but I don't know. It's just... It's not where I live now, so... It's just... It's just crippled by that one.
Oh, God. It's true, though, because... Christ, the palaver of me and you going when it first opened.
Yeah, we tried months and months, and then we finally got there, and I ordered the Crunchwrap Supreme, because I was like, that's the thing from Taco Bell.
Yeah.
And it felt like, you know when like you make your own wraps, and you haven't filled it very well, and you're rubbish at rolling, so there's just like more air than there is filling? Just
like amateur.
It was kind of like that.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll give it a miss then.
Yeah, and then I put that experience off, because I was just like... To be fair, it's still really busy. This is still really new. And, like, at the time, my nose was really blocked. So it's like, to be fair, it's not a good first example.
The odds were against you.
Yeah. You're going to get no taste, just heat.
Yeah.
Like, that's a texture.
So I did, like, a home delivery a while after we went and, like, did, like, a proper order because I was able to actually go through the menu and not get that, like... weird pressure you get when you get to the counter of a place you've never been before.
30 people behind you because it's new.
Yeah. And you're just like, they're like, what do you want? And I'm like, I don't know what you do. But cool
food,
story.
Please.
So I did like a home delivery and was like able to order like all the things I'd like heard about and things like that. And it was just all really rubbish.
Oh, man. Like, I might give it a miss.
I don't enjoy the chips because they cover them in like some Cajun thing. You'd probably love them.
They're standard, right, aren't they?
Yeah, it's like standard that they... It's like a Taco Bell seasoning, and I'm pretty sure it's just like Cajun spice and probably sugar.
You think you
had
old?
Yeah.
I'll have some Taco Bell fries, please.
I think they also do another version that is spicy. The normal ones, they're not too spicy.
Oh, right, okay.
They're so just like
you can't get much hotter than the standard ones. That's what we're talking about. Yeah.
And the Taco Bell, like, Happy Meal equivalent, like 5 year olds.
Yeah. And I tried like these like cinnamon twists that I always hear about in America.
Yeah.
And it's basically the texture of like a prawn cracker.
Right.
It's like that texture, but it's twisted and it's just covered in sugar and cinnamon.
So that's right up your street then.
You would have thought so.
But no, they're not just, executed well.
It's like you could tell that they've been deep fried in oil. Whereas like prawn crackers, I feel like you just kind of forget that that's how they're made. But I don't know. It just... Long story short, Taco Bell's a bit rubbish.
Okay, I'll avoid that then.
Yeah, it just lacked a lot of flavour. It just feels like it could have been dunked in an ocean full of salt.
Oh, and then it would have... Selling it to me.
Yeah. No, I'm just going extra hard because I know I'm being recorded, so...
you know, like, Taco Bell will get in contact with you now and be like, right, just, we're trying to, like, you know... Like,
could you be our wrong?
So, yeah, please, like, we'll sponsor you.
Yeah, because I'm over here with the best palate ever. Eating sweets for dinner. Block nose.
Do you still have a block nose?
Yeah.
Like, just because a minute ago you were like, oh, back when I had a block nose.
Oh, yeah, that was like... when it. I don't know, it gets worse in the winter.
Basically, he's had a block nose for like...
About 2 years?
2 years, whatever. And it got so bad that I've actually got a tally on my notes on my phone of every time he buys a nasal spray.
Instead of fed nose spray.
Oh my God.
Because I want to see how much he spends on nose spray.
You need to
year.
Add three more to your thing.
Do I?
Yeah.
Three more sprays or 3 more pounds?
3 more sprays.
How much are they, each one?
Well, I bought 2 for £6 once, and that was really good.
That's
They're
really,
normally £4 each.
What number is it?
I'm actually going to have a look.
Just out of curiosity.
Yeah, I think I've bought like 3 since I last told you.
We saw you yesterday, didn't we? I'm joking.
Rob's nose spray 2020. So like, that's not even tip of the iceberg, is it, really?
Oh my God,
£14,000 is what it says.
Yeah, it's
£4.10, £4.30, £4.18. It's
the
just
best one I got was from Wilkinson's. I think it was like £2. It's pretty good.
Was it?
I probably should just go to the doctors. I probably just got like a deviated septum
that, or just get them to sponsor this, and then you just get them for free, don't you? We just send them to you.
I should have fed them. I'm neglecting going to the doctors to sort out the real issue. Can I just keep getting supply of your nose spray? One that says on the packaging, do not use longer than 7 days, but that's a different issue.
Temporary fix.
Yeah. God, I feel like I've been talking a lot.
You loving that.
That's good.
What else?
Oh!
Wait, Jesus. The glass
moved.
Glass is alive.
What else did you get up to this week, Tom?
So, I got sunburnt playing basketball.
which
is great.
I did actually see you got...
Oh, man, yeah, I'm a flaky little snake boy at the moment.
Yeah,
shedding his skin.
So, a while back, I got burnt so bad that my body started to, like, swell up. It was retaining water, and it was so red.
Yeah.
Did
you blister?
Yeah, like crazy. Like,
oh god, that sounds horrible.
Bubble wrap around my neck, sort of.
Oh my god.
No, it was really bad. And ever since then, like, my body's just started to, you know, take a beating from the sun.
Yeah.
And I was thinking of it, like, what did I look like? And just a mess. Just like if Hellboy fell in a well and died and then just kept living. Like, that's the red bloatedness of just...
Oh my god.
Yeah, it was bad. So yeah, it's just like it's come back a little bit. I'm not that bad, obviously. I think I look a lot worse than what Faye tells me I look like. But
yeah.
But it wasn't even that bad, like we were saying on the way here. Like, it was cloudy and
That's what gets you though, it's the overcast summer days.
Yeah. I got windburn to hell as well. It was awful. But yeah, I'm still there's a proper little
wooden teeth
laser beam. But yeah, so still recovering from that. But yeah, that's what I get for trying to get back into basketball.
Wait, were you blistered this time?
No, I was just like red. It wasn't like near purple. I looked awful for like 4 days. So thank God for lockdown.
Are you sure we're going to add to it later?
I'm definitely going to put some like Factor 50 on.
Yeah, I've got some Factor 50. I only use Factor 50 because what's the point?
Because why go lower?
Yeah, I don't know.
Not worth the risk.
I don't care about tanning.
Yeah, well, that's the thing. Like, I've gone brown-ish, and it's just not worth the...
Yeah.
That leads us perfectly. Speaking of smelly boys, let's move on to Netflix and Spill. Let's do it.
Wow,
so Netflix and Spill. Should we start with Tom?
You
been watching anything new?
Yeah-ish. It's not new. A new series has just come out of it. It's called What We Do in the Shadows.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's... It was a film from, like, 2014 or 15. So I've seen the film,
but I haven't seen the TV show.
Oh, the TV show's great. Well, I mean, the film's good as well, but...
Sorry.
So
you've seen what? You've seen the film?
You've seen other things.
What We Do in the Shadows.
When?
Quite a while ago, actually. I can't remember it.
Kev made me watch it.
No, I watched it with Rob. It was the film came out ages ago.
Yeah, it's
and we watched it as part of like our research for Pine.
Yeah.
For our latest film. It was really funny.
Oh,
it's just
good.
Like the Australian accent and the vampires. It's just so funny. Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
It's a mockumentary.
Yeah.
Sort of thing. And it's about a group of vampires that share like a mansion. And there's like they're different ages, so there's one guy who like sleeps in a coffin and he's like 400 years old.
I've seen stuff of this.
Yeah, and they lure like two people in, and there's this, and they're like they serve them food and it's spaghetti, and one of them somehow turns the guy, he's like eating his spaghetti, and the spaghetti doesn't change, but all of a sudden he's like, oh my god, I'm eating snakes.
It's just ridiculous.
Like, and he just turns it to snakes and they're just laughing because it's just a little prank.
They're clearly like bored vampires that don't really know how to vampire.
Yeah.
Like that. I've only just seen the film like, I don't know, a couple of weeks back, but we've been watching the TV show. Season 3 has just come out. It's either 2 or 3, I can't remember what it is. Yeah. And the actors and the actress in that is hilarious, like Matt Berry, and I've totally forgot the other people's names, so we might need to cut that out.
Is Toast in it?
Toast.
Isn't he? He's the guy who does the money calm that advert at the moment. I think he called like Toast of London.
No, that's Matt Berry. Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's him. Yeah, he's in IT Crowd and things like that. Yeah, he's a dude. But they have all the same traits as like Bram Stoker's Dracula and stuff like that, so they can turn into bats and stuff, but when he turns into a bat he has to announce it for some reason. He just goes bat. It's like crazy good VFX. It's still like, I think it's produced by Taika Waititi as well, so
oh, nice.
Thor Ragnarok. Yeah, he's a dude. and obviously master. He's in the film as well, he plays a vampire, so he's just continued it across. But yeah, no, it's a really, really good, funny show. Do recommend it.
Is it on Netflix?
It's on BBC iPlayer.
Oh!
Of all things, yeah.
Another gem.
So if you've got a TV license,
get on it.
Get on it.
If you don't, get a TV license.
How about you, Aiden? You watching anything new?
Nothing new. Still chugging through This Is Us.
Yeah. Great show. Great show.
This guy turned me on to.
Mm-hmm.
Cracking. Yeah. Quite close to catching up with everything now. So I can start internet stalking all the cast and do all that, because I've been holding off until I'm completely caught up.
Yeah, do your classic over-the-top like research.
Yeah, they're all just such interesting people. I've only ever heard of one of the actors in there.
Oh, that's
so,
cool.
So like, they're all just very new people to me.
When that's a thing, isn't it?
You don't want to Google them as well, for spoiler sake, I think you were saying earlier as well. Like, that's, especially with this sort of show.
You don't want to like Google someone and then be like, they left the show in this season.
There'd be like a Google image of them like dead on the floor or something. I'm like, no!
Not like this!
So, I'm like four episodes away from being completely caught up with everyone else.
Is it an ongoing season? Like, are they still making...
Yeah, so they've announced that they're going to go to season 6, and it will be written to the end of season 6, so they're not like going to get cancelled or anything like that.
What season are they on now?
4 is the current one.
Yeah.
Season 5 should be out by like September, October-ish.
Mm. Okay.
So yeah, we'll see what happens, because like now Prime has it. Mm-hmm. We might get it a little bit earlier.
Yeah.
Whereas before we had to wait like 2 years for it or something, so like that was a bit annoying. But
Yeah, it is annoying.
Cracking show. What about you, Rob?
I haven't been watching anything new. I've started rewatching Community.
Oh, nice.
It's just so good. I'm like, because it's been a nice amount of time since I last like watched it or even had it on the background.
Mm.
And it's just so funny. It's so ridiculous.
What's it like now rewatching it and seeing Donald Glover in...
Weird.
In it? So yeah, because he's kind of...
Because like, I was following Donald Glover for years. Like, I got onto him because of Community. And I started watching Community during season 2.
Mm-hmm.
And at the time, Donald Glover was doing some pretty awful music, to be honest. Like,
oh, yeah, I remember you saying his early stuff.
And he was doing like a tour that was half comedy and half music, because he didn't know if he wanted to do like stand-up comedy or music, but he just kind of did both. So his like talent for being really good at a lot of things kind of started then.
Yeah.
And then he released one song called Freaks and Geeks, and that was like the first Got Your Ears... to stand up.
Got your ears to stand up.
Perk the ears up.
Yeah.
That's what I was trying to say.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was like the first song he did, it just felt like he was getting somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
And then he just did so much between like releasing that Freaks and Geeks song and like where he is near the end of Community. It's just insane. Like during that period, he was like writing for 30 Rock.
Yeah.
He was a writer on 30 Rock. He appears in, I think, 2 episodes as just like a extra. It's just crazy to see where he is now.
Star Wars.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's been in so much.
Marvel films as well. Most of the cast of Community as well have been in Marvel films.
Lando Calrissian?
Calrissian, yeah.
Yeah, that is his name, yeah.
He also plays Miles Morales' uncle in the MCU as well. He's in Homecoming.
Yeah.
So that's like the closest thing I think we'll get to him.
Yeah.
But now we've got this whole Spider-Verse thing, so eventually Sony and Disney might come up with something. That would be cool if they did, because that's what everyone wants. But yeah, he's a dude.
So should we move on to Banger of the Week?
Shall we?
Yeah. Please.
Should we let our co-host give off the first banger?
This is a banger. Now let's just see what this sounds like.
Yeah, so what have you got for us today?
So this was a really hard decision for me, because I only recently stumbled across this band, which is a little bit annoying considering my love for what the band previously was Fightstar. So music is stuck in 2006 to 2015. So I didn't realize that the band, well, I knew they split up, but I didn't realize they kind of got back together through the bass player Dan Haig. So he's made this new band called Gunship.
Okay.
That I've only just been introduced to this year, which is awful.
They've been around a while.
They've been around since 2015.
Oh.
Yeah, so that hurt.
Oh.
But yeah, I was like, no way.
You should look back at Reading posters, see if they were playing.
Oh God, I'd be so gutted if they were like, so the band's very like 80s synth wave, heavy, like just cool Ooh, cool nice. Noises, cool sounds, like very like do-do-do-do, old school loose drums.
I'm liking the sound of this.
And yeah, so it's a choice of three songs, like the main three that they've got. But I've chose a song called Dark All Day, which features, I think she's called Indiana. And she was kind of famous a couple years ago, or last year. She like features on some songs, and she's pretty big, but I don't really know much about her. But yeah, this song is just ridiculous, and all the music videos that go with it.
All of them?
All of, like, for any gunship music videos, okay. Like 80s, VHS, old school animated, very like Kung Fury-esque. Ooh, like, nice. Yeah, it's kind of like a parody, but without actually taking the mic. We'll be right back. Yeah, so that's Dark All Day by Gunship.
Really like that.
Nice.
That was really cool.
Really cool.
Exactly what you explained.
Yeah. Just 80s synthwave heavy drums.
Yeah,
like it was. It was like Far Cry.
Oh, Blood Dragon.
Blood Dragon, yeah. Just that.
Yeah.
Very much so.
80s. Mate, that's sax.
Yeah.
Ooh, so cool to hear that kind of stuff in a song like that.
If you put that sax on some bread, it would just dissolve. Because it was buttery.
Oh, hell.
He got there.
Yeah, that was sweet.
That was really cool. I do feel like that sort of genre is coming back, because a lot of the big artists that have come up through like emo rap and goth rap, it's all been emotional, sad boys.
Oh yeah, yeah. They have that format, don't they? Of just like, I'm so angry, and then I'm gonna sing real cool. Yeah. And then they go back to the rap and the rock. It's cool. Yeah. That's from Joel Dommett. I can't take that as well. Yeah.
Should we move on to fabulous stories from our friends?
Well, we ain't got a fabulous story from our friend because you refused to call her up.
No.
Kat, I'm sorry, Bubba.
Bubba.
Let me tell you something, shitbird.
You ain't gonna believe this.
Listen up! Now this is a story all about him.
Wow. Really? Well, then tell it to me.
Have you got any stories, Tom?
So that was my sixth bullet point. That is empty.
Yeah, empty. Ooh.
My empty bullet point. I had five.
I have a very short story.
Hit it.
It was just quite funny. So I went out. I was going to a reclamation place like last week, just to see if it was still open at the moment. And I like pulled into a roundabout, and it's, you know, like when you have those roundabouts where pretty much no one ever use it, a roundabout, they just, because everyone is going from the same exit to entrance, it might as well be a straight road with a turn off. Mm-hmm. So a lot of the times people don't expect you to turn and go like right on the roundabout, and I was going around the corner and it was a hot day, so this dude had his window right down and he just pulled out and like wasn't expecting me to go right, like proper cut me off. And instead of like any reaction, he just like sped up and just like made like a really shocked face, like right at my eyes. It was just like, oh! And he just like pouted his mouth in like a, like how you whistle. I'm trying to explain it for people listening. He was just like, like, and just drove off. And I wasn't angry at all. I was just laughing because it was just so random. Just come around the corner, I was just like, oh, idiot. And I'm like, look at him, he just does that face and just like jets off.
You famously don't get like road rage or anything though, do you? You're quite open about that. You give every single person the benefit of the doubt.
Yeah. That came about because I was in the car with Tash one time and she's kind of the opposite.
Yeah. She like rages at everything.
She's a bit of a road rager.
Oh no, I don't know that.
Yeah. And I'm like the complete opposite. If someone cuts me off, I'm like, oh, they probably had a reason for it.
They're probably in a rush.
Yeah.
They've got a bad day or something.
Yeah. Maybe they're new to the area.
Yeah, that was it. They must be new to the area. They don't know what lane.
Oh, man, that's
like, no, they're just dicks.
Yeah. Well, the way I always see it, though, is like, I've done things to people in the past. Like, I've accidentally cut someone off, like, pure accident. And, like, I've, like, almost ran over a bike.
Right. Just the bike. Guy was gone.
A stationary bike.
I was trying to take a joke. I was trying to make a joke, but it went south, and now I'm embarrassed.
Now I've embarrassed.
No. Oh god. Hi, I'm Ivan embarrassed.
Oh god.
Oh god.
See, that was my story.
I could tell. Quick one of the only time I've ever been mad at you.
Yeah, I do keep thinking about that story.
Tom Donaghy is famously the nicest person ever, so there's very few moments I can think of where you could ever get mad at him. Yeah. But there is one, and only one time in my life where I've ever been, like, for about an hour, I was mad at him.
Yeah, from retelling it, you were very mad at him.
I was just...
Yeah, man, I felt bad.
It's more devastation.
Yeah, it makes sense once the story's been told a bit more.
So this is...
like, why he was so mad.
So this was, 2008? maybe?
Yeah, it was a while back.
This is ages ago.
Yeah.
And we live out in Staddy. You know, all it is fields. What else are you going to do? You're just going to film each other jumping in bushes and stuff. That's just what it was.
Heavily and, influenced by Jackass and...
Yeah, we were just... Oh, yeah.
Oh my God. Sorry. I was...
So we grew up with all that stuff and we just go out and... muck about doing our own stuff.
You were having like a filming session up the field, weren't you?
We went around with an older school friend, Gavin Dodd. So we're going around the field looking for opportunities of stuff we can just film.
Yeah.
And we come across a tree, and this is... I see this tree and I'm like, cool, Tom, do you want to jump out of this and film you? Like, there was no bush to jump into, and it was quite high.
Oh yeah.
But it was one of those things where it was high when you're up there, but it didn't look very good on camera.
Yeah, it didn't translate whatsoever.
There was absolutely no payoff in doing this at all. The thing with my old video camera back then, I had this like dodgy third-party battery, so you could only have it on for like 5 minutes before I had to go home and charge it for...
Yeah.
So it was like, I was there filming Tom up in this tree, like counting himself down, like, okay, I'm going to... Oh, I can't do it. And I was just like, oh, God, let me do it. I was already a bit like, oh, for God's sake, man. And then we were walking back down to my house because we had had enough. And on the way, we stumbled across this red dog poo bin in the hot summer sun. Yeah.
It was like it's one of those proper like, old school ones where it's kind of like on a pole.
Oh yeah,
And it was on like it was downhill as well. Oh, so obviously I'm like, right, dude, we gotta like mess ourselves up on this dog poo bin. Again, thinking back now, I was like, why?
Why? Yeah,
like,
so, why?
For funny. And so I'm like, as soon as I did the tree, Tom, I'll get down real low, I'll have my fisheye lens, like, let's...
Basically try and hurt yourself involving this on camera, because it'll make good footage sort of
it's,
thing.
It's a lot harder to intentionally get messed up on something like that.
Yeah, and your body rejects it a little bit.
Yeah, you always, like, clamp up, because you know, like, what you're about to do to yourself. You were running up to it over and over again, just stopping, like, hitting the bin, like, oh, for God's sake! Hold on, I'll do it now. Yeah, out of frustration, I was just like, yeah, held the camera, went up, and like I said, it's a quite a like steep downhill run up to it, so it's that fact alone makes it a bit higher. Yeah. You got further to fall, and I dive, just both my knees clip the top of it, and I land straight on my face. Proper scorpion, like legs flip over my back.
Kick yourself in the back of the head, scorpion.
Yeah. Which is, to be honest, exactly what you wanted.
That was the exact image of like what we needed, but I never thought it would actually happen.
Yeah. It should be me.
Yeah, because I thought like I was doing it in a way of like, I'm going to really oversell this and make it look really rough.
Yeah, you didn't have to.
I didn't have to. It was a total like, I lost control of my body.
Yeah.
And I instantly bolted up. Then I was just like, oh, yeah,
I knew
oh,
that was
going to just I mean, like ran off camera. And I was like, oh, you know what? As hurt as I am right now, we got it. Yeah. Holy shit, that's literally the clip. We watched it back.
God.
Tom being the nice guy he is, he saw it happening through his eyes out of concern and shock. The camera kind of like moved to the left and I was like kind of cut out of frame a little bit
because he was watching you kind of like turned
away from the action for a second. You must have known that was coming and I was like insisting we watch it back. You're like, no, let's make sure you're right first. I was like, no, let's see this. Like,
my fear with filming with a fisheye as well is that I didn't realise how far back I actually was with it being like a wide angle.
It always looks a lot closer.
You can literally be touching someone's nose with that fisheye and see their whole face.
So it was like a a mixture of it was very hectic.
Okay, and your camera's not ruined, you didn't kick it.
We watched it back and I was like, oh, for God's sake, Tom, no.
Yeah.
And there was a one time where your nice nature made me really angry with you, and I strapped off home, didn't I? Because I was like, I've literally nearly broken my back. I've got nothing to show for it.
Like 30% like the frame is filmed with like Aiden's shoe. It's just like barely in it.
But
I mean, to be fair, like when I watched the clip, I didn't really notice the camera going away.
No, when I calmed down and actually watched it, I was like, it's fine. But yeah,
you can totally tell what happened.
Because I properly landed on my face and stuff, I was like, I wanted to see that.
Yeah, there's just that, there's that thing of like when you're, as well, when you're in pain or like when you really need the toilet, like at like you can get agitated so fast.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Because you're just like, I just need to.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's, I feel like, especially when you're in pain, if someone especially like that misses it, you're gonna
there was that the initial shock of doing it, and I was like, you know, I was like winded, and I was, you can hear me like,
yeah, you like sprung proper up, was just like,
no.
Get some air back in you.
Yeah, and once I collected myself, I was like, right, everything's intact, I'm all right, I haven't broken my back. And I was just so happy, I was like, I yeah. just proper scorpion myself. Like, yeah. I could never do that again if I tried.
Yeah,
and that was kind of the thing I watched. I was like, I can't do that again, Tom, what the, what the hell?
It just shows the extent you have to go to be angry with Tom.
Yeah, like, and even then it was so, maybe like you didn't do anything bad.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
For what? I think I was going to get internet famous, putting it on YouTube or something. It's like, we've made it, Tom, I'm a scorpion. Yeah.
This is the clip.
Was that the big fisheye?
It was just like a crappy, the first one got the clip on, yeah. So it wasn't proper fisheye, so you couldn't, we were trying to get the really cool low angles, but we didn't have the wideness for it, so
didn't have the pay slip.
No, not then. I wasn't a pot washer at that point, so
you weren't.
No, I wasn't.
Oh, so you didn't have that.
This was a long time ago.
This is like the gap between finishing year 11 and starting sixth form, I think.
Oh yeah.
So this is like
when your parents start being like, you know, you really should look for a job. Yeah, I was like, I don't want to.
I wouldn't like that.
So yeah, that was the only time I ever got mad at Tom. Good 12 years ago.
Yeah. Pain-induced anger.
Yeah.
I know what you said, but it definitely sounded like you said pain-induced tango.
Pain-induced tango. If you want to see the clip of me face-planting, scroll down to the very first video uploaded on this channel. There it is,
if you're listening on YouTube.
And if you're on SoundCloud,
go on YouTube and have a look.
Send me a message and I'll send you a private link.
Yeah, I'll send you the raw footage.
Do you remember what happened the first? So I lived on Mutley for a while and then I moved to Plimstock. I was like, cool, everything's going good. And then something happened financially where I had to move back to Mutley. And the first time...
Oh, because it was like we had talked so much about like how we wanted to just get back out to status quo, like the suburbs, and get out of the student hustle and bustle of Mutley, because it's, you know, it can be quite rough, can't it?
Yeah.
And, you know, it was that just unfortunate time where you had to move back out there. We all sort of took our first like walk down the strip of Mutley playing like since you had moved in. And
yeah, so this guy at one of the junctions just slammed his brakes on. He was this, like, someone was crossing the road or something, and the car was filled with like a guy and I think it was like three girls or something,
like young.
Yeah,
they were quite young. They were clearly like first year students or something like that. And they absolutely kicked the crap out of this dude. And this guy, just because he, you know, he wasn't crossing the road fast enough or something along those lines.
Oh my god, I've never heard this.
Yeah, this was crazy. This was like, what, welcome back.
Got out the car,
absolutely beat the crap out of him.
He like punched the windows out of the car.
He wrecked that car. He like put his foot through, like, was it the back window or something?
Wait, yeah.
Wait, what?
So the guy crossing the road.
Yeah.
He got basically beaten up by these three women.
Yeah.
And he couldn't fight back or anything. So his thing was to just, I'm going to mess up your car.
Oh, did he?
And like, as they were driving away.
Yeah, he was trying to drive away, get back in the car. Shit. He just put his foot through it. I think it was like where the boot is. Just,
oh my God.
Yeah,
because that was like domino side. It was like, we were sort of walking towards Boomerang.
Right in front of the church.
Yeah, it was just one of those things. Like, welcome back to Mutley. I was like,
welcome back. Really like
this to time? Be fair, that's quite an exaggerated.
Yeah,
like
yeah,
that's
it
not
just
normal.
So happened to be the first like.
Yeah,
let's take a walk down Mutley. Like,
would anyone ever get that angry
when you're like in the area when something like that happens? Like when he was putting his fish through a window or whatever, they sounded like gunshots.
Yeah, they were so loud, but. Everyone were like the Boomerang and all the other pubs are. Everyone, we didn't really know what to do.
Yeah. So we were just out onto the road,
in shock, just watching it. And then, obviously, being the current age that it is, everyone just got their phones out and started filming it, which is like, oh, okay, maybe.
All the people that were day drinking wanted to get involved because it's like, oh, get on.
Yeah.
Opportunity
It is a weird thing because you kind of, in that sort of situation, you know the car's going to zoom off and you know that guy's just going to walk home.
Yeah.
Because he smashed their windows. He kind of retaliated. He's lost.
Oh yeah, like
he's kind of like lost the right to.
No one won in that whatsoever.
He
got beaten up to hell. Like it was ridiculous. And that car, Jesus Christ, damages.
So my banger of the week is the same guy as I chose in the first ever banger of the week. Is Gus Dapperton.
Gus Dapperton.
Yeah, he's released a song called Posthumorous, and it's just really good. There's a couple like proper gravelly screams in it. As
sold.
Well. Yeah. But yeah, it's just really good. I really like this sort of new, more acoustic based stuff that he's been making. So here we go. Also, don't forget, you can listen to all of these songs on our Only Ones Laughing Bangers podcast playlist on Spotify.
Yeah.
Here we go. There we have it. That was Gus Dapperton with posthumous.
Woo! Tom good. Had a good shout.
Yeah, so I thought it kind of reminded me of 21 Pilots and Jack Johnson. Just like if they had a baby.
Yeah, and which I said that makes sense because I love both of those bands.
What did you used to fall asleep to as a kid?
I was looking over your way being like, does he want me to say that again?
Does that make me sound cool?
I used to go to sleep listening to Jack Johnson In Between Dreams album like every night for 2 years as a kid. And my mum would, this was when it had to play on a CD player, and my mum would come in and turn it off every night.
That's the cutest thing ever, isn't it?
So yeah, let's have a quick game of What You Laughing At.
Let's do it.
So this week I didn't get a laugh, so it's just going to be Tom and Aiden.
Unbelievable.
Well, you told me not to bother, so I just
didn't. I said get one each this time.
You said to me like me and Tom are going to have one each, so you don't need to bother, so I just did that. I just didn't bother.
Is that shovel working on that gravel that you the gravel?
What?
For God's sake. Damn
it. Is that shovel work with gravel? Because I need to repave my garden.
That's why I added this, so this is all coming out.
Nah.
You little bitch.
Yeah, just leave that in. Right, so here we are again with What You Laughing At. We've got some corkers lined up for you today.
Yeah.
Luckily, I didn't bring one. It's just Tom and Aiden. They've got one each.
It's only... Okay, so this one is like... maybe 2 seconds long, so you gotta really listen to this one.
Okay. Sorry. Okay.
Ooh, hang on a minute.
See, this is interesting because now I feel like we're battling to get it.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Could you play it again?
It sounded.
You want again? Yeah.
So I this can't is even an interesting one. Oh, male I feel or female? Like
I can like see the face, but I can't see the person.
You're hungry in your mouth.
One more time. This okay, is the
this
last.
This is the last
one.
Play.
You sure?
Yeah.
Right.
I feel like I got a good guess, but
okay.
I don't think it's right, but I can't think of anything else.
Who wants to go first?
I've got someone in mind, but I'm skeptical. It seems a bit too random.
I don't know her name, but she was like the evil gym teacher from Glee.
That woman. What's her name?
She's
I know exactly.
Got
who you
like
are,
the
but...
same role in everything she's in.
Yeah,
just like the slightly weird.
Oh God, what's her name? I know who you're on about. I've
is
totally
her name
gone
like
blank.
Sarah something?
No.
But yeah, the.
No.
I mean, it's obviously not her because otherwise you would have told me her name. So.
Yeah. So
what's your guess? Aiden?
My guess. I'm not confident with it, but it's all I can visualise when I hear it, so I'm going to go for Glenn Close.
No. Oh my God, they're nearly like the same person in my head, is what you said. Right? They sometimes like cross over.
Should we do one more listen?
Yeah, do one more listen. One more. Come on.
Oh, it's really annoying. It's so recognisable, but I can't...
It's definitely one of those ones where you will kick yourself.
Yeah.
She's got like a bit of a smoker voice going on.
A bit raspy.
It sounds like someone who's older as well. Like I feel like she... like in my head it's like Meryl Streep.
Okay, so it's Mel B.
Oh my God, yes it is, isn't it? Yeah. So obvious now.
Yeah. Meryl Streep, Glenn Close.
I feel like it's someone older. I was like, ooh.
Sorry, Mel B.
Yeah, Jesus.
We know you're an avid listener.
Yeah. That was a good one.
For some reason, that was like the one when I was looking at like, oh yeah, laugh. Like that just came straight to my mind. I was like, cool, I'm not going to deviate from that because I could spend hours on this.
Not going to deviate except from that.
No.
Okay, that was enough.
Right, moving on to AD's.
Okay, this is real short.
Oh God.
There was someone else at the end there, but
yeah,
I couldn't count.
Oh no, out. I really don't know.
It's short though, isn't it? What?
Go again. Yeah,
it's literally a second long.
I feel like it's a footballer, but it...
Oh, I think I know.
Ooh.
Can you tell us what, like, profession they're in?
No.
Okay, I think for that reason, I'm going to say, is it Greg James?
Is that your...
That's a really good guess.
Yeah, that's a good guess.
Well, I've got another one last.
Oh, is it that dude?
Do you recognise who that is at the end? No. Coming in to talk?
I feel like because you can't tell us anything about it, it's something very specific, like a radio DJ or...
Yeah, and the audio quality sounds pretty good.
Are they on a talk show? Oh, is it someone from Radio X? A Matt Hill special?
Consider the source.
So, no.
Okay, I'm just going to do a wild guess. John Frusciante.
Chili Peppers guitarist.
Yeah.
Is that your final guess?
Yeah, I'm going to go with that. Because I really don't know. It's quite a... I feel like that laugh is quite a generic laugh. Mm-hmm. Like that could fit on a lot of people.
Yeah.
It's incorrect.
Okay.
So I'm thinking like...
It's not John Frusciante. Do you want a bonus play seeing as...
Yeah.
Yeah,
I'll have one. Go for it.
Yeah, I'm sticking with John Frusciante.
Okay. It's still wrong.
I'm trying to do the tune. Oh, I have no idea. This is a really tough one. I'm trying to play...
I feel like your Greg James one, that was quite a good guess.
Oh, I don't want to stick to that, though, because the reaction you got there, I'm playing the person, not the game.
I'm trying to purposely...
He's trying to deviate the septum.
Oh, right.
Okay. No, I'm purposely trying not to give anything away.
I'd say Greg James, then.
It's incorrect.
What is it? Who is it?
The laugh belongs to a Mr. Quentin Tarantino.
Oh!
And the chap that comes in at the end is John from Ross.
Oh, my God.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I would have never...
Oh, it's so obvious.
I would have never have got that.
Jesus.
I should have been able to picture that weirdly shaped mouth.
Jonathan Ross's
if
hair.
If I
there,
had a clip of him going, and then you would have got it instantly.
Or him just going, feet.
Loves the feet.
Oh. Yeah. Don't know where you're putting your phone away, mate. You got banger of the week.
Hey, baby.
For God's... Oh, okay.
Yeah. So I think it's time for the last banger of the week. That's right. We've got three for you this week.
Lucky guys.
So now it's on to Aiden. Banger of the week.
This is a banger. Now let's just see what this sounds like.
So this has been a banger for many weeks for me. I was struggling this week, so I thought, let's take it back. This is by a band called Nothing But Thieves.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Tom's eyes are rolling in the back of his head. Yes. He's loving it. And this is one of my faves. It's called Broken Machine from the album of the same name.
So, Faye, turn it up.
Yeah, turn this one up loud.
You're going to love it.
I've started to jam, my world's jam, I'm just a broken machine with all the layers of dust. Some things have started to fail, some things have some.
I'm
And there we have it. Nothing But Thieves, Broken Machine. Absolute banger. Love that one.
That was really good.
That was good.
I tell you what, that was the perfect song to play with the weather that we're having.
Hey.
That felt proper summery.
Mm.
I like that.
It's got a very chilled build up and then that chorus explodes in.
Mm.
It's a good in.
Beauty. Beauty.
That. A lot of the bands that you play, they always just feel like Reading festival bands.
Yeah.
Like a lot of the bands that you play, it's I just imagine being sat in the sun in a field looking at a massive stage that had the same vibe. Chilled out summer festivals.
Fun fact, when I first heard that song I thought it was a female vocalist.
Dude's got range as well. He's very much like that Matt Bellamy. From Muse, like he can sound like a guitar solo. With his voice, he hits the mental notes. Yeah,
it's insane, isn't it? So I think that's pretty much it for today. Anybody got any last words?
Cool. So I'd like to just have a bit of a shameless plug.
Do it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're all about that.
Payment for your time.
Cool then. So me and my brother, Roy McCaffrey, aka Black Mesa, we have these Friday night streams where every Friday night, 9 till midnight, he does DJ streams, live DJ streams with other DJs. So it's house, techno, anything, the full works. But it's a good time.
Where is it streamed?
It's streamed on YouTube, Twitch, Mixcloud, Facebook, youtube.com /bunker17.
Cool thing about the streams is Tom's in charge of like the crazy visuals that you see along with the stream. So it's on a green screen and there's just all this interactive craziness going on in the background, and it's just good old time, good party. So tune in on Friday, get your night started right.
Go to the YouTube channel and click the bell so then you get notified when they go live. That's the easiest way to do it.
Yeah
The link will be in the description of both platforms you're listening to this on. It'll be on the SoundCloud and YouTube description. Go down, click subscribe, tell them we sent you.
It's a good thing to have like on in the background if you're hosting a little get together. Because it's not ending when lockdown ends, is it?
No, we're going to continue it. We're going to see how far we can take it and how big we can grow with it. So eventually, hopefully, we might start doing venues and other things like that. But yeah, as of now, it's still in the house, but we're getting some people around, so it's a bit more of a party vibe. But like you said, even if you just have it on in the background, it's a good time.
Make sure you pester them about bringing T-shirts and merch out, because I want a Bunker 17 T-shirt.
Yeah.
That can be arranged.
I feel like Aiden's just a collector of merch, but not merch that exists. He likes to make it for himself.
To make it exist.
I like to fly the flag. I like to support.
It's a pioneer.
Yeah.
Yeah, he likes to get a shirt for himself and not his co-host on a podcast.
Yeah, I'm sat here and the only one's laughing top. And Rob sat wearing the same old crap. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah, thanks again for your time. Hopefully you enjoyed.
Yeah, it was cool. Thanks for having me.
We'll have you back on because felt easier to do.
Yeah, and if you enjoyed having a pineapple last week, why don't you give us two this time?
Yeah, comment below two pineapples if you think you're hard enough.
Dubs pineapple.
Yeah,
and we'll be very thankful. I'm going to
we'll
give
look
you.
At it and be like, sweet.
We'll give you a little heart on the comment.
Yeah.
So. You got that to look forward to. See you next week.
See you next week. Thanks, Tom.
Thanks, Tom. Thanks for listening.